Will football replace cooking? Of course not. They're two different things. Let's go here. It says photography is the art, application, and practice of creating durable images by recording light. By recording light. Is this recording light? This was created by AI. No, this is graphic design. You don't need light to create this. You just need a computer. You download templates and you either start doing it manually or you say, Alexa or Photoshop, please make the faces ugly. You know, that's a macro command. So football is not cooking. Photography is not graphics design. Those are different things. So let's now see what is art. The expression or application of human creative skill and imagination. Human. So art requires a human creator, by definition. Oh, but this is such crazy shit. Hieronymus Bosch, the Dutch painter, was doing shit like that 600 years ago. You heard that right. 600 years ago. So, and back to the definition, I cannot write that well. I cannot reproduce this writing so perfect, so to speak, mathematically perfect. Doesn't mean that my computer is an artist. Every time I type the keyboard, some perfectly written letters come up, right? Doesn't mean that the computer is an artist, even if it starts creating text by itself. You all know the random text generators, right? You just go to random text generator and you refresh it and you come up with different random text that makes no sense whatsoever. It's complete bullshit.
An example of someone who mentors an individual with poor literacy skills. He created a GPT-powered Gmail account that could essentially turn his client's poor writing into a professional interaction. Original text. Sally, I am starts work at yours Monday from Dave. Business version.
Dear Sally, I hope this email finds you well. I'm writing to let you know that I will be starting work with you on Monday. I'm really looking forward to getting started. If you have any questions or need any help with anything, please don't hesitate to get in touch. Best wishes, Dave.
One user was testing how well it would work for mental health support. He noted that it worked better than any other mental health chat he'd ever used. I'm not feeling well.
I'm sorry to hear that. Is there anything I can do to help you feel better? Do you need any medication or medical attention? It's important to take care of your health and well-being. Let me know if there's anything I can do to assist you.
I'm just feeling sad and don't know what to do.
It's completely normal to feel sad at times, especially during difficult times. It's important to take care of yourself and practice self-care in order.
What intelligence? This is a template of a corporate email. A typical template. I think Microsoft Outlook puts these out automatically. First sentence, completely useless. The second one could be shortened. This one, completely useless. Last sentence, completely useless. I already know that if I have any questions, I will ask the guy. As far as this one, this is an insult to everyone's intelligence. All the sentences are useless. This is the automatic message I'm getting every time I call my doctor and I'm waiting on the phone. Instead of playing some stupid music in the background, they figured, let's play some stupid text instead to amuse the patient. And I'm not amused at all because it's insulting my intelligence on top of it. And if you make the mistake of start pressing buttons, if it asks you to press buttons, it's gotta be about 1,000 pre-recorded messages, so you will never stop pressing buttons. At any rate, photography is not graphics design. By definition, there are two different things. And art requires a human creator, by definition. And this is normally where the video should stop, because the questions are satisfied. But this next part could probably change your life and the way you think, even at your job.
The Tesla, when it's navigating, it just makes, if you ever turn on its features, well, anything, actually just cruise control. The number of times we've been on an interstate, we drive 10, 40, 70, and 80 all the time. And then we're on an interstate, and all of a sudden we're going 75 miles an hour, and all of a sudden the car screeches the brakes. The dogs get thrown forward, and it slows down. If there's nobody in the rearview mirror that we have to speed up for, I let it go all the way down, go down 25 miles an hour on an interstate. A Tesla with nothing around, no cars around, no nothing. Sometimes there is a car around, you say that must have been it, but sometimes with nothing around, this is so dangerous. It's happened to us 100 times, wow. At least, because we drive so much. And then if you turn on the steering, where it's steering, my gosh, sometimes it kind of goes over the line a little, and there's a truck right there, or if a truck kind of moves towards you a little, a human driver would just pull away a few inches. And it doesn't do that. And I remember recently, I'm driving along, and all of a sudden, there's a semi on my right. The car lurched towards the semi, and I had to quickly grab control.
Wow.
I mean, that would have been death. This is just horrible, horrible, assuming that these algorithms can do what a dumbest human could do.
Assuming that these algorithms can do what the dumbest human can do. They can't. And in my industry, for example, project managers in the translation industry are trying to copy this AI automatic logic in their own messaging and their own mode of operation. And they have no idea how stupid they sound. Personally, I have named them all Talulas. This is the definition of a Talula. If you want to spread it around, feel free to do so.
And the trouble is, we don't know how the brain's wired. We do not know how the brain does that stuff. I know, because I was a psychology major, and we don't even know that our memories are in the brain. Memory of this meeting okay. Here? Don't know that's in the brain. I took all the strongest subjects in memory and psychology and read every book I could and went walking on the streets of Berkeley and buying more books from the older days. And where's memory? The best they had was, it must be everywhere, because you take any part of the brain out and no memory gets lost from the rat. So it must be everywhere.
Wow.
But now I came up with something 40 years ago. I have to go back. Well, 1981, whatever that was, 40 years ago. I came up with a statement to make fun of the fact that the books don't know anything. I said the strongest correlation you can come up with is that between the ages of 6 and 10, as we had learned, you lose two things. Your childhood autobiographic memories, things that you've done as a child, and you lose your teeth.
Right.
And that's the strongest, best correlation. Now it's 2022 or something, one of these years, 2021. Yeah. I don't know what it is. I don't do years. But you can look up, you can search for teeth memory. You're going to be shocked what you find today. So not to mention Alzheimer's tests in the saliva and the gums.
Well, this one is easy to decipher because memories are strongly associated with emotions and physical sensations like pain. Teeth are a constant feeling in toddlers because they're growing and then they fall. But when they're all fallen, this sensation is not there anymore. And emotions are not really mature in toddlers, so they're not strong enough to support strong memories. So these memories fade away fairly easily. It's also, of course, that toddlers cannot really explain most of what's happening around them. If you cannot understand something, you're not going to remember it that easily, right? If you understand, let's say, a physics chapter, you will remember it easily. If you don't understand it, you're not going to remember it. Everything that happens and affects the way we think, the way we process information, which is never pure information, it's always interpreted into something, is psychosomatic. You are supposed to read books, for example. Let's say reading books is a good thing, blah, blah, blah. Well, when you read a book, it is supposed to provoke some feelings. It's not just information, especially if it's a fiction book. The information is useless because it's fiction. But it's the whole emotional stage, different stages in each sentence or paragraph that makes you remember the book. If the text has no feelings, does not invoke any feelings, most likely you're not going to remember it. Here is something photographically related, because you think you know everything. The main reason that you can't immediately understand your camera manual is that the text is machine written and machine translated. It's monotonous. It has no contrast. If you read the Hemingway book, one word will appear one time, another word will appear four times, another one three times. And there are sometimes same sentences phrased in different ways. That's why you remember it. Because it's got contrast, it's got variation. If I make everything consistent, you're not going to remember it. You're not going to even understand it. Can you remember this image? Maybe. You've seen a lot like this image, right? You're probably not going to remember it 3-4 months down the road. Can you remember this one? Of course you will remember it. Because it's funny. It evokes an emotion. Will you remember this image 6 months from now? It has a lot of information. The other ones were just black and white. Very little information in the RAW file. This one has a lot. But you're not going to remember it. Because it does not evoke any emotion. Well, you probably will remember it because I told you now. So you are evoking yourself an emotion, challenging yourself to remember it and prove me wrong, which is also an emotion. And as I also said in a previous video, we are bodies, and whatever happens to our bodies, hot or cold, a pain or pleasure, is part of our intelligence. Unfortunately, and that's a huge unfortunately, most schools in the last few decades taught their students to believe that intelligence is the amount of information you can hold in your memory. So you had a lot of people become stupid encyclopedias. So you had people trying to store a lot of information in their minds, information that didn't make sense to them, so they forgot this information after a few months, completely forgotten. And at the same time, they could not explain anything. And that is why, for example, they will believe everything that the political parties will tell them. Because they themselves are not used to explain, they are used to just swallow information.
Okay, you're on a freeway, and there's a merger lane coming in. Well, Tesla starts driving, the lane gets wider where it is on the lines, and it starts driving like a drunk person. But the car coming up ahead, as a smart human, you would just see, we're gonna be equal, so I'll back off a little.
Mm-hmm.
Just easy to do. Tesla lets you go right up next to it, and it screeches the brake on to get out of the way, you know, because it has to by then. This is just not the way human beings ever think. And they used to make it sound like, oh, artificial intelligence will be like a human. We have eyes. The Tesla has cameras, and it'll be able to do what a human does. And the trouble is, we don't know how the brain's wired.
Now, because I've been programming myself MT for the last 12 years on a daily basis, what if I told you that every single correct sentence that Google Translate produces has been already written and or corrected by a human? Every single one. You probably say, no, that's impossible. Would you like me to make a video about it? Here is something that will really shock you. Do you know that we are getting assignments to spell Greek words with every possible wrong spelling even 14 years ago? So the agency would give you 500 words correctly spelled, and right next to them you would write 5 possible wrong spellings at least. But did you think that your autocorrect works by intelligence? Here's a shocker, right? So to close this video, let me repeat. Photography requires recording of light. If you did not do recording of light, but you're just bullshitting things on your computer screen, that's not photography, that's graphic design. Or computer-generated images, whatever you want to call it. If you didn't involve a camera, a device to record light. And secondly, only humans can produce art by definition. If a computer produces it, it's something different. It's not art. It may be nice, it may be pleasant, but it's something different. Maybe we could call it computer-generated designs, random designs, because art by definition is produced only by humans. And since humans' intelligence is psychosomatic, the same artist even cannot produce two identical paintings, one after the other. They're going to be slightly different. The computer, on the other hand, either randomly or by program, can produce millions of copies. And they have no value. A penny a dozen. And as I also said in a previous video, we are bodies. And whatever happens to our bodies, hot or cold, a pain or pleasure, is part of our intelligence. So why is the government putting so much money in AI? Well, faster technology for military advantage, and you will never see this technology. You will only get the Photoshop bullshit version, the Disney version. This technology, you'll never see it. And Silicon Valley crooks lost their investors, we all know how they're doing lately, and are now targeting the taxpayers through their lobbyists in Washington. And you know that politicians are imbeciles when it comes to technology, so they give them taxpayer money. So if it's not art, what is it? NFTs. NFTs, you already know that. It's just that people stopped buying them, so they had to come up with a different name. So what to do with AI? Use it. It's a tool. Alexa, fix the white balance. Alexa, fix my nose in this image. All the things that you cannot do with a mouse right now because they're too complicated. It's a tool. You know, 40 years ago, when I first played chess with a computer, I thought it was kind of like magic. Now, I think that all computers are freaking stupid. They're just tools. So, thanks a lot. Bye.